Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Stick around, I have some important information to share with you. La Palma has been having another earthquake swarm. So unsettling. The earthquakes have become that the scientists that monitor the earthquake and volcanic eruptions there on La Palma, bringing back memories of the last eruption, that the scientists have issued a statement to the tourists of the island that are visiting the island, telling them that there is nothing to worry about, even though they have lied in the past. These same scientists are now admitting they do not know why the island did not collapse into the ocean. They thought it was going to do that while they told the world that there was no chance of a major collapse of the island, creating a huge tsunami that would reach the east coast of the United States in about 8 hours after that occurred. And these same scientists are now telling the tourists that the uptick of recent earthquakes, the largest being almost a magnitude 3.0, is nothing to worry about. Here is one paper that I translated. It says, according to volcanologist Pablo González, a system of fissures that opened during the last phase of the eruption may be responsible for the fact that a giant catastrophic landslide did not occur. The scientist points out, as if it was a great suspense movie, this eruption of Cumbre Vieja left the biggest surprise for its last act. These volcanic tectonic structural changes must be critically evaluated to determine if their release magmatic and or gravitational stresses on the flank of the volcano. For the expert, the sequence of events that prevented a catastrophic collapse from occurring will be especially revealing. He says that he should give hints on how to assess the probability of these for other systems. So now the scientists are debating why it didn't collapse, because they actually expected a collapse of the volcano, a collapse of the island, and it didn't happen, and now they're debating why it didn't happen. That only means one thing, that it still could happen in the future. And it just really frustrates me, makes me mad that so much I found within the last 24 hours, not just with this, but the other volcanic eruption in Portugal that's not being discussed. There was an asteroid that impacted the Earth back on March 11th. They only found it 2 hours before it did hit the Earth. I'll do a report about that. But there's been so much that I found within the last 24 hours about things that could have happened if it was not for the grace of God sparing us. I am really sad. Disappointed. Yeah, the governments are not going to warn you about some type of disaster coming. So now we got an earthquake swarm going on. The scientists once again are lying to the people, telling them there's nothing to worry about. The government was supposed to come in and provide housing for the people. There's still over 400 people living in hotels that were supposed to be hotels for tourists. Over 60 earthquakes were registered, I believe it was Thursday, maybe Friday. This is today's. This is the spectrogram. I don't know if you can see up here. The hours, we got two more, and more, and more. It looks like they're averaging about three every hour. This is universal time between 13 and 1400 hours. The BS that they're giving the people is that these earthquakes are being caused by the water that's mixed in with the lava as the magma chamber cools. A very distinct line of melt. And this is what it's currently showing between 16 and 1700 hours. It's currently 11:40 a.m. Central Daylight Time. Right now it is 4:40 p.m. in La Palma. This here is as big as I can make this image of the recent earthquakes. They are not showing today's earthquake here on IGN.es. These are from yesterday, a 1.8, a 1.6, a 1.8. I don't know if I can make that bigger. No, I cannot. There is a little blue dot, you'll see it there, that lights up for the location. A 1.8, another 1.8, a 1.9, a 2.1. Right along the fault system. You notice that? A 2.0, a 2.5. Now that's on the other side of the rift. A 1.7, a 2.0, a 2.6, a 1.5. Yeah, these are right along their rift. 1.9, 1.7. I want to find that one that was almost... Okay, that one's a 2.4. Right along the coast. I want to see if I can find a 2.5 again on the rift. 2.4. Hold on. All right, that's what I was looking for, the 2.9. Let's see, intensity level between 1 and 2. I'm sure they're lying about that too. A depth of 28 kilometers. That's deep. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. So that would be about 17 and a half miles. Let's see. Yeah, it was 28 kilometers. These other ones are shallower, 16 kilometers. That would be about 9.5 miles. See, yeah, this is coming up from the mantle. Then there is some that are shallower. 10 kilometers, 4 kilometers, right there. Yeah, lie to me once and I catch you. I never trust anything that you will say again. So, what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for your support. You know who you are. You can support my work by subscribing to Patreon. I'm also on Twitter and also on BitChute. Please stay safe and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.